Lord, we thank you for waking us this morning, God, and starting us on our way, bringing us again, God, into your house of worship. And now, Lord, as we have gathered here today, God, we ask you to order our minds, our spirits, God, and our tongues in your word and in your way. We ask you, God, to anoint our spirits afresh. Oh, God, that we may perfectly praise thee and worship thee. In the matchless name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Say good morning. To all of you, it's good to see you all this morning. Amen. God allow us to lay down last night and to wake up this morning in our right mind. And for that, we should be thankful. Amen. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. I couldn't wait for Sunday to get here. Amen. So yesterday, I was praising him. On Friday, I was giving him glory. On Thursday, I was calling on his name. On Wednesday, I was saying, thank you, Jesus. On Tuesday, I was saying, praise thee, the Lord. Amen. On Monday, I just can't wait to come into the house to let him know how good he has been to me. And he's been good to you. Amen. He shook you. He woke you. He told you, hey, get on up and go into St. Peter. And for that, it's good to see y'all this morning. Thank those that are visiting with us or online with us via Zoom or social media. Thank you for being in this service today. Amen. Let us stand as we call to worship. The Lord is in his holy temple, and all the earth keep silent before him. Seated for the invocation. Eternal God, we come this morning thanking you, Lord, for the lying down last night, rise up this morning, thanking you for protecting us, Lord, from last Sunday to this Sunday. Father, we come right now invoking your Holy Spirit, Lord, to enter into this place. Lord, to shake us up this morning. Lord, to guide us this morning. Lord, to comfort us and encourage us to lift you up, Father. For you said that if you be lifted up, you will draw all men. Now, Father, we ask that if there's anything that was standing our way, remove it right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, forgive us for any thought, word, or deed that have entered in our minds or entered to our hearts. Cast them in the sea of forgetfulness. Remember them no more against us, Lord. Lord, and we pray, Lord, that you would allow us, Lord, to worship and praise you in spirit and truth. Now, Lord, give us a little more voice to sing praises unto you. Give us a lot more strength, Lord, to lift you up this morning so you can get the glory. We ask these things in the matchless mighty name of Jesus. Amen, amen. Amen. Let us stand as we sing the hymn of praise, I Have Found a Friend in Jesus.
standing for our responsive reading, the sixth Sunday in Kingdom Tide, the Lord's Supper, Matthew 26, verses 26 through 36. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body."
And he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of it.
For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out into the Mount of Olives.
Then said Jesus unto them, "All ye shall be offended because of me this night, for it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock shall be scattered abroad.
But after I am risen again, I will go before you into Galilee."
Peter answered and said to him, "Though all men shall be offended because of thee, yet will I never be offended."
Jesus said unto him, "Verily I say unto thee, that this night before the cock crow, thou shalt deny me thrice."
Peter said unto him, "Though I should die with thee, yet will I not deny thee." Likewise also said all the disciples.
All. Then cometh Jesus with them into a place called Gethsemane, and said unto the disciples, "Sit ye here, while I go and pray yonder." Have you seen the glory, Patri?
Glory be to the Father.
Confirm my faith through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From this he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the universal church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may now be seated.
The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty, and all the earth rejoiced, and all the earth rejoiced. He wrapped himself in light. The darkness tries to hide. It trembles at his voice. It trembles at his voice. And how great is our God. Sing it with me. How great is our God. Oh, we'll see how great. How great. Hey. Lamb. He's the Lion and the Lamb. And how great is our God. Sing with me, how great
is our God.
Oh, we see how great, how great.
Scripture going to come from the book of Mark chapter 9, verses 14 through 29. I think this is King James Bible. I'm reading from the big one here. And it read as follows. And when he came to his disciples, he saw a great multitude about them, and the scribes questioned with him. And straightway, all the people, when they beheld him, were greatly amazed, and running to him, saluted him. And he asked the scribes, what question ye with them? And one of the multitude answered and said, Master, I have brought unto thee my son, which hath a dumb spirit. And wheresoever he taketh him, he teareth him, and he foameth and gnasheth with his teeth, and penneth away. And I have spake to thy disciples that they should cast him out, and they could not. He answered him and said, O faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I suffer you? Bring him unto me. And they brought him unto him. And when he saw him straightway, the spirit tear him, and he fell on the ground and Wallet Foreman. And he asked his father, how long is it ago since this came unto him? And he said, of a child. And oft times it had cast him into the fire and into the waters to destroy him. But if thou canst do anything, have compassion on us and help us. Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. And straightway the father of the child cried out and said with tears, Lord, I believe, help thou mine unbelief. When Jesus saw that the people came running together, he rebuked the foul spirit, saying unto him, thou dumb and deaf spirit, I charge thee, come out of him and enter no more unto him. And the spirit cried and rent him sore and came out of him, and he was as one dead, in so much that many said, he is dead. But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. And when he was coming to the house, his disciples asked him privately, why could not we cast him out? And he said unto them, by this kind come forth, by nothing but by prayer and fasting. Amen. Let us pray. Merciful God, in the loving name of Jesus Christ, we come again before you saying thank you. Thank you, Lord, for making death behave. Thank you for blessing us to see this first day of October, the first Sunday of October, and almost, Lord, thank you for blessing us to almost see a new year to come in. But we just come to you, just want to say thank you, most importantly, Lord, for dying for our sins. Now, God, as we continue to walk along this journey, we ask you to take us by the hand, God, and lead us, Lord. And to the day, God, our time is up on this side. Oh, we can wake up on the other side and be in your presence. The word is, Lord, living in Christ, dying is gain. Oh, we just want to say thank you, God, for paying for our ransom, paying our sins. Now we just want to pray at this time for all those who are battling sickness or whatever illness, Lord. We ask you this time, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, to just strengthen them, God. Remind them, God, to let them know, God, you have all power given to you over heaven and earth. Oh, we pray for those right now that bereave, and ask you at this time, continue to uplift the prayer for the McCrary family. Let them know, God, you'll be with them today. You'll be with them tomorrow. You'll be with them forever. Your word is this, God. You said we all just come to you. You will send the comforter. And we know, God, you is a comforting God. We just pray at this time, God, for the communities, praying for this country in general, for those right now who may be in politicians' spots or whatever, God, in leadership roles. Give them the knowledge, Lord, the understanding, Lord. Let them know, God, that this is not, you don't want it to be divided. You want us to all be in unity, all come together as one. Because you didn't just die for one race, you died for the world's sins. And we just pray at this time, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, God, for the pastor of this church, praying at this time, God, for all pastors in general. Lord, we just ask you right now, God, that the word that go forth, let it go with understanding, God. Open people's minds, hearts, and ears. And the speaker, Lord, let the speaker decrease it while you increase it. Lord, we just want to say thank you. We know, God, at this time, Lord, we ask you at this time, continue just prayer, Lord, for the St. Peter's just church family. Oh, the devil think he had won, God. We've been hit by a few deaths, Lord, but we know, God, right now, all power again belongs to you over heaven and earth. And we just pray for those, for whatever reason, who could not make it today to church, God, for whatever situations that may abound on them. We ask you this time, Lord, to just be with them. We give all thanks to you for this in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Let the church say amen. Amen.
Allow the chosen generation head to the annex, please.
Let's give our choir a hand for blessing us this morning. And the musicians. I don't want the musicians to get upset with me. Amen. I want to remind the church that there's sign-up sheets in the back for those that are not part of a ministry and would like to be a part. Please take time to go back and look. Amen. And put your name where you fit in. Get in where you fit in. Amen. Let us pray for those that are traveling. Members, we got quite a few that are traveling. That God be with them in their travel. Those that may be sick that we don't know about, we don't know. But if you just go to God and pray and just ask him to cover our members that may be sick, that may be down, may be discouraged about one thing or another, God will hear, amen, and he'll answer. Ministry of Kindness, it's time for our Ministry of Kindness, if our stewards and ushers would come. We're asking for $5. Ours have been cash apped already. Amen. Thank God for cash app. Those that are able to give, please give five to help us with our ministry of kindness. How does God loves abide in anyone who has the world's good and see a brother or sister in need and yet refuses to help them. Blessed is he that considers the poor. The Lord will deliver him in time of trouble. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth where moth and rust corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. Whatever you would do that men should do to you, do even so to them, for this is the law and the prophets. He who sows sparingly shall also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully shall reap bountifully. Every man according as he purposes in his heart. So let him give not grudgingly, nor of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver. Let us stand. All things come of thee. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen. Please be seated.
Somebody just hummed that to themselves. Somebody ought to just say, lead me. Lead me, Lord. God Himself make. God Himself can only do that if you just ask Him to lead you. Not just lead you, but lead you in the path of righteousness. Make thy way plain. God is able to do that. When you try and do it in your own strength, you can barely see your way. But God will make it plain. Not only will He make it plain, He will move obstacles out of your way if you just let Him lead you. Amen. Some of us need to hear that. Because we lead our own self and not be led by God. Some of us lead ourselves to sit down when God wants us to stand up. Lead ourselves to go north when God wants us to go south. Lead ourselves to go east when God wants us to go west. Lead ourselves away from the church when God wants you to come into the church. Ask Him to lead you. I guarantee if you let Him lead you, He'll make your pathway smooth and your crooked road straight. Your tall hills low. Amen. I know what He can do. Thank you, choir. Look like our choir is shrinking. But we need to get back to the way we used to be. Amen. I'm going to get off my little box and give you all some words that God has given me. Let us pray. Father God, we come in the name of Jesus, asking at this time, Father, that You will decrease me, increase You, increase Your word, increase Your power, increase Your Holy Spirit. Let Your word use me as Your vessel. Let Your word go forth. Lord, let us not be doers. Let us not be hearers only, Father, but be doers of Your holy word. Father, You told us our word we should hide within our heart, that we might not sin against it. So, Father, we ask, Lord, that Your word would go forth, and because it's quick and powerful and will not return to You void. Let us hear Your word today and act on it. In the name of Jesus we ask. Amen. 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 This morning I want to look into Mark as the devil has been so busy, not just yesterday and last week, but all year long. And trying to attack our children. Amen. And trying to attack our parents, our friends. He's just busy. I mean, I can't open up the news without seeing some type of shooting, some type of stabbing, some type of physical abuse and verbal abuse. So many things are going on in this world. Even kids are still, children, young adults are trying to take weapons into college campuses. so many things are going on into the schools. Amen. We need to hear from God. And Mark, thank you, Reverend Eastman, for the reading of the scripture and the prayer. Minister Stewart for leading us with affirmation of faith and our responsive reading. And all of you, our ushers who've stood at the door and the greeters who've greeted. I hope the greeters, did y'all smile today? Did they see through your mask? Amen. In Mark 9, verse 29 and 28, it says in 28, and when he was come into the house, his disciples asked him privately, why could we not cast him out? And he said unto them, this kind can come forth by fast, by nothing but prayer and fasting. You know, sometimes we get away from fasting. A lot of us know how to pray. Amen. All of us do. Because all you got to do is open your mouth and the Spirit will give you the things to say. But, we don't fast until January. And it may go from the 1st to the 5th. We say for the whole year we're going to, our favorite line is we're going to shed some of these pounds. And while we're talking about it, we got a bowl of ice cream. Amen. I'm going to tell the truth. While we're talking about getting on that bike, it hadn't been removed from the cradle yet. Amen. We talk about prayer and fasting, but do we really fast and pray? This morning I want to talk about the power of faith to overcome the enemy. The enemy is so busy, brothers and sisters, that we can defeat him if we have the power of God to be able to do it. The Christian life is like a hand that's given to us. It's like a land, amen, of hills and valleys. In this passage, we see in one day there was a disciple. The disciples can move from glory to heaven to the attacks of the devil. And just like one day we could be glorying in God, Salisharis, the next day we're trying to see what happened when the devil began to attack us. One day we can be telling God, thank you for protecting and watching over us, and the next day the devil try and send somebody to attack us. One day we could be saying, Lord, thank you for the things that you have given me, and the next day the devil is coming trying to take those things away. Just like the disciples had some issues and trying to keep straight, we have some issues on trying to keep straight. Jesus had just come down from the mountain with Elijah and Moses. And they were up in the Mount Transfiguration where Jesus was turned Cinderella, in which they was having this conversation. They was having this meeting. Amen. And Jesus heard the voice of his father when he was on the mountain after Peter said, hey, Lord, it is good for all of us to be here. Let's build 3 tabernacles, one for Moses, one for Elijah, and one for you. And God said, look, we only need but one. Amen. And God spoke from heaven and said, this is my beloved son, whom I'm well pleased, hear ye him. I'm going to wake you up in a minute. I got 3 short points. Amen. And God spoke from heaven. And when Jesus and his 3 disciples came down from the mountain of transfiguration, he was met by this demon-possessed boy, amen, and a troubled father. Anybody ever had any trouble with their children? I know I ain't the only one, amen. He was met, amen, and the scribes there were, they were there, and the rest of the disciples, amen. However, Peter, James, and John were on the mountain with Jesus, but the disciples nor the scribes that's supposed to be smarter than anybody else, the scribes that's supposed to know the scriptures, they could not heal this little boy. Amen. And we need to enjoy a mountaintop experience while we can, because if you haven't had some valley experience, like my grandparents used to say, just keep on living. You can live godly and we'll still have some valleys to go through. Amen. We can have a good time on Sunday worshiping God and encouraging one another. And on Monday, it seemed like all hell just broke loose. On Tuesday, your supervisor act like he or she don't have no sense, amen. On Wednesday, your children getting on your last nerve. And on Thursday, your spouse seem like they have lost their mind, amen. On Friday, somebody in the church said something you didn't like. On Saturday, amen. Even on Fridays, you know y'all go to them high school games? And your alma mater didn't win. Amen. They didn't win, you get upset with the world. On Saturday, you're in your college team, the game, it give you a migraine. Amen. I asked Benny this morning, was he all right, you know? Because on Sundays, we had to have counseling sessions, you know, on how Alabama played. And, you know, usually he'll say, I'm all right this morning, Pastor. But today he said, no, I might need a little counseling. But in this world, the Bible says that we will have trials and tribulations, but the word of God says, be of good cheer, amen. I have overcome the world. We are more than conquerors. And my first point I want to leave with you is this man, this father was depressed. A depressed father. When we look at this text, we see a sad and depressed father that's looking for his son some help. And his father had heard about Jesus and brought his son to Jesus. He probably heard that he was a miracle worker, a promise keeper, a way maker. This father probably heard that he was a healer, amen, a doctor above all doctors. He probably heard that he made the lame walk and the blind to see and the deaf to hear. He probably even heard that Jesus fed 5,000 men, not counting women and children. He probably heard that he changed water into wine to keep the party going. Anybody ever been at a party? And you ran, I ain't gonna say you ran out of wine, but you ran out of liquor. It's some sad folks in the house, amen. The party ends at that point. I can go on home. You're looking through the cooler, and I'm not saying I've done this. I'm just illustrating. I'm looking through the cooler, and all I see is ice. It's time to go. But the party, you know, he probably heard that, amen. So this father figured if he brought his son to Jesus, that Jesus would heal him. But when he got there, Jesus was still on the mountain, but the disciples were there. But the Bible said they couldn't heal this little boy. They should have known how to do this because they had been with Jesus. They was taught by Jesus. They was hanging with Jesus. Jesus empowered them to be able to do so. But the Bible said they could not. And his father, he brought his son to Jesus and he said they couldn't heal him. And church, I don't know about how many of you are parents that are here today that's having problems with your children because I try to mind my own business. Amen. 1 Thessalonians 4 said, be good and careful to work with your hands, minding your own business. I got too much going on to be in your business. Amen. You know, I got too much business of my own to be trying to inspect anyone else. But it said we do our best to live a quiet life. And this father, he tried to help his son. So some of you may be dealing with a boy or girl that act like you hadn't raised them. Amen. Some of you may be dealing with a child who's now decided to smell themselves and think they're grown. Some of you may be dealing with a child with some sort of addiction. You're struggling to raise a child that you have
to compete with Facebook and TikTok and Twitter and making sure they're living right. You're trying so hard to get your children to see that those are bad role models, amen, but they still want to go out and do whatever they want to do. You have watched and you have taught them from birth, and you fed them, you have clothed them, amen. You live right in front of them. They broke your heart. You brought them to Sunday school and morning worship, but still things went left when you thought they were going right. Like this father, we understand the heartbreak, amen, of watching a child being possessed by the demons, amen. He had a demonic spirit, and when you have a demonic spirit, it make you talk back and be disobedient. Anybody ever talk back? You know, the spirit saying, don't open your mouth. But that demonic spirit saying, go ahead and give them a piece of your mind. Anybody ever done that? It's just me. Amen. I like when somebody can admit the truth. Amen. I saw some hands raised, and all of our hands have been up, because I know at one point, if you didn't talk back to your mom or dad, it didn't come out. It was in your mind. You were definitely thinking about it. You know, I used to be telling my granddad all the time a piece of my mind, but he never heard it. I'd find myself getting up off the floor. You've done all you can for your children, amen. When they're possessed, he had this demonic spirit, and when you have that spirit, amen, it's not the spirit of God to make you disrespect, to make a child disrespect their parents. It's a demonic spirit that will tell you to go ahead and steal something from someone. It's a demonic spirit that will tell you to go and try and rob a store or a bank. It's a demonic spirit that will tell you to stay at home and don't go to church because the devil don't want you to hear God's word. I wish I had a witness. It's a demonic spirit that will tell a child not to listen to the principal or the teacher. When your folks raise you right, amen, and you go and do what you want to, that's a demonic spirit that's controlling. It's a demonic spirit that will tell you not to go work in the church or even go to church when you're able to get into God's house. Even though this father had a demon possession child, he brought him to the right place. He brought him to Jesus. And brothers and sisters, amen, you can't fight demons in your own strength, especially being at the wrong place. You want help, but you won't take him where the help could get, where you can get help. The Bible says that when someone is sick among you, you can call the elders. You won't bring them to where somebody can pray for them to get those things removed. You don't call your brothers and sisters, you know, because you've been too busy talking about other folks. And they're saying, well, if they're talking about them, that prayer ain't finna get to God. The second thing is, that was a difficult failure. The disciples failed. Anybody ever failed a test? Well, everybody was straight A students. Amen. The toy you made all A's. Amen. We fail some kind of test somewhere. We're not perfect. Amen. And if you're perfect, amen, I want to see if you can do what Jesus did. I'm going to bring a water pot. Miss Hill is going to go in there and get some water and bring it out here, and I want to see you change it to wine. Amen. I want to see you get Sister Cotton off of that walker. They were able to do that. Amen. They failed. There were 9 disciples, and the Bible said the Father brought them to him, but they could not heal them. Amen. Imagine, because the Bible said, where 2 or 3 or more get gathered in my name, I'd be in the midst. It was 9 of them. Amen. And they could not together heal this boy. They needed the power of God, Sister Mildred, and brothers and sisters, every one of us need the power of God. And the church need the power of God. And when folks are looking for a church that believe that Jesus died and rose again, they're looking for power within that church. And this should show God's power when they walk in here. Some, when they come to visit this church, they should feel God's power. If they come in here, they need to feel His presence. If they enter into this house, they need to feel His spirit. If they come into this house, they need to be able to find God. Amen. Folks should be able to come in and be restored and have some restoration. And if they come in here and cannot find it, amen, we will not be operating in the power of God. You know, folks come in here want some healing and they want some restoration. They can't get it. Too many people looking them up and down and crossing their eyes and amen. When they look at that, they ain't thinking about healing. They wonder if they're in the right place or not. Amen. They should be able to come in here and feel His power. And if we claim to be the church, then we ought to act like it. Because when people come in here and don't see it or feel it, they'll think we're operating falsely. The disciples fail because, like many of us, they did not recognize the only power they had was reflected from Jesus. And we need to recognize that God give us the power to cast out demons. All you got to do is say it in Jesus' name. He give us the authority. They failed, amen. And the authority that Jesus had given them was effective only if they exercised it by faith. But they didn't have enough faith that they can heal him. But faith got to be done, and discipline and devotion has to take place in order for God's power to miss. I'm almost through. And they should have been able to heal this boy, because when Jesus was around, they were able to heal him in Jesus' presence. Look, these disciples were empowered, amen, by Jesus to cast out demons, but they forgot about Jesus and tried to cast the demons out in their own power. And folks, when we operate in our own power, there's nothing that we can do like what Jesus can do. When we try and order our own steps, then we can't do what God's power allows us to do. But if we seek Him first, the kingdom of God and His righteousness, all the things that will be that we need will be added unto us. They forgot. And when you forget, when you have your valley experiences, when you're going through trials and tribulations and forget that God has all power, then you'll never get anywhere. But when you come to yourself, like the guy in the pig pen, the Bible said he came to himself, then realize to know that you got God's power. And the only way you can cast out demons is through fasting and prayer. And brothers and sisters, if you're trying to help your child, amen, if you're trying to help your family, if you're trying to help it in your own strength, well, let me suggest to you that you should fast and pray. I'm getting ready to close. Fast and pray over your children. Fast and pray over your marriage. Fast and pray over your job. Fast and pray over your extended family. Fast and pray over your grandchildren. Fast and pray even over your finances. Fast and pray over anxiety and depression. Fast and pray over your health. Fast and pray over your bills, over your home. And if you do, your failures will go away. Amen. The last point, that was a dangerous friend. It said the demonic spirit was torturing this little boy to the point where he couldn't talk. It was torturing to the point where he couldn't hear. He said the Bible said he was deaf and mute. The boy was sick and he couldn't even tell his daddy what was wrong with him. Amen. And some of us have gotten to the sick where we couldn't talk to God, but in our mind, God knows what we're going through. And we can speak to Him through our heart, and God can do something about it. Amen. He couldn't tell his daddy what was wrong with him. The spirit that kept him from speaking, but it also kept him deaf. And when a demonic spirit get hold of our children, amen, we can talk all we want. They don't hear nothing we're saying because they're controlled by the spirit. Y'all ever been talking to your child? Those that have, and I don't know your child. Have you ever been talking to someone and they ain't heard nothing you said? Amen.
And you say, just repeat what I said. Well, I don't remember what you said.
But you can talk all you want and they won't hear nothing. And when it get hold of your loved ones or your spouse, amen, they can't say anything because they're being controlled. This spirit had this boy flipping and twisting, amen, on the ground and foaming at the mouth as well. Look, the demon know who Jesus is, amen, because when the father get to him, when he gets to Jesus, the demon started even tearing and flipping him around on the ground. And Jesus asked the father, he said, how long he been like this? And the father said, amen, he had been like this since a child. He said, the devil has twisted and thrown him into the fire and tried to drown him in the water. And this demonic spirit tried to kill him. And the father said, I brought him to your disciples and they couldn't do nothing about it. The father said, Jesus, if you can do anything, amen, please help. And Jesus said, since you asked, amen, since the disciples had failed, the desperate father was not even, amen, sure that Jesus could succeed. So he said, if you can do anything, he said to the one that was there from the beginning, amen, and will be there to the end, if you can do anything, he said to the one that knew no sin, one that walked on water, amen, he said to the one that calmed the storm, Jesus, if you can do anything, but Jesus said to the father, if you can believe, amen, all things are possible. And church, I'm saying to you that if you can believe that God is, if you can believe that Jesus died and was resurrected from the dead and he's sitting on the right hand of his father, if you can believe, all things are possible. Amen. The father said, Jesus, I believe, but help my unbelief. I believe what you're saying, but I still got some doubts. We can read the word of God all the time, and some folks will still have some doubts. He said, I believe, but I need you to help my unbelief. Amen. The father was honest enough to admit his own unbelief and ask Jesus to help him. He said, Lord, I believe, but my faith get weak sometimes. Sometimes our faith get a little weak. Lord, I heard you help others. I need you to help me right now. My belief is not that strong. My faith is not that strong. I hadn't read the Bible in a long time. I don't know how to pray. Help my unbelief. I don't know church hymns. Help my unbelief. I've never been to Sunday school. Help my unbelief. I don't have a relationship with God. In fact, I don't know. I don't even know God. But Jesus, if you can do anything, help my unbelief. Jesus, if you can believe it, he said it. Amen. Jesus said it, Sister Young. Hey, if you can just believe it, I can make it happen. Jesus said, bring your boy to me. Amen. My disciples did their best they could, but bring them to me. And church, when you take your children, when you take your spouse, when you take your job to Jesus, he'll do something about it. When the school can't help you, take them to Jesus. When the teacher has flipped out on you, take them to Jesus. When the marriage counselor say, I can't help, take it to Jesus. When the supervisor said they don't understand, take it to Jesus. When the AA said, I can't help, take it to Jesus. When you done all you can to help your child, amen, take them to Jesus. There's some of us that have done everything else as a Christian, but somebody had took us to Jesus. Some of us here ran the streets when we were young. We club hopped after club. We hopped from this club to that club, amen. We went from this house to that house, but we had some praying folks in our family. Mama never stopped praying for you. Daddy never stopped praying for you. Grandma and granddaddy never stopped praying. Even though they're going to be with the Lord, we can still remember their prayers. Jesus said, bring that boy to me. Jesus didn't speak to the boy. Jesus didn't speak to the boy's father. another, amen. But Jesus spoke to the demonic spirit, amen. And sometimes we need to speak to that thing that's holding us back from God. Sometimes we need to speak to that person that's holding us back from God. He didn't speak to him. He told this spirit, he said, "You dumb and deaf spirit, I charge you to come out and don't go back in him." And when that demonic spirit heard him, he twisted the boy one more time. Then he came out of it. He left the boy like he was dead. The Bible said that Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. I wish I had a witness that know when you went to Jesus, he lifted you up. When you had a bowed down head, you went to Jesus and he lifted you up. When you were depressed, you went to Jesus and he lifted you up. When your husband let you down, Jesus lifts you up. When your children broke your heart, Jesus lifts you up. When your bills had you down, Jesus lifts you up. And church, we got to pray and fast to have the power over the enemy. Solomon, God answers prayers. Amen. God is a prayer answering God. Hannah prayed and asked God for a son. Solomon prayed and asked God for wisdom. David prayed and asked God for forgiveness. Hezekiah prayed and asked God for healing. Jonah prayed and asked God for deliverance. Aaron prayed and asked God to bless Israel. Jabez prayed and asked God to enlarge his territory. Jesus prayed for his disciples that they would be saved. And when you pray and fast often, God recognizes your voice. God come to rescue you because you and God have a relationship. God is our Father and we're his children. Paul says, "For this cause, because I bow my knees to the Father of the Lord Jesus Christ, I fast and pray." Church, if you have a cause and you have a need, God can do something about it. Just fast and pray. If you need a breakthrough, just fast and pray. If you need healing, ask him in prayer. If you need a friend, he'll be a true friend. Just fast and pray. If you're worried and don't know what to do, pray and fast. He's a burden bearer. When your children are acting a fool, fast and pray. Anybody ever been let loose when you pray to God? If it's bondage, guilt and shame, if it's addiction, if it's health, if it's problem after problem, pray and fast. Confused minds, court orders, pray and fast. Crazy supervisors, pray and fast. If you're crooked, amen, let Jesus straighten you out. If you're bent, Jesus can straighten you up. If you're broken, Jesus can mend you back together. Envy and strife, amen, fast and pray. Hatred, when you pray, turns to love. Sorrow, when you pray, turns to joy. In the midst of storms, he'll give you peace. Weakness, he turned into strength. Bitterness, he turned into sweetness. Sadness, he turned into happiness. Is there anyone that know that if you ever tried Jesus and put him through the test, Jesus said he's a way maker. Amen. He's the truth and the life. No man come to the Father but by him. He's a rock in the weary land, a shelter in the time of storm, bread when you're hungry, water when you're thirsty, everlasting to everlasting. Our joy early in the morning and late in the evening. Our Savior of the world, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the Prince of peace, the bright in the morning star, a bridge over troubled water. He took your sins and my sins and he went to the cross, but church, he didn't stay dead. The Bible said early Sunday morning, he got up. With all power, not some power, but with all power. And the Bible said, he's sitting on the right hand of God, interceding for us. That when we mess up, he say, "Lord, I didn't pay you for it. Forgive him." But listen, after Jesus heals his boy, after he heals the boy, the disciples waited. You know how we wait until everybody gone? So we can talk about somebody. The Bible says They waited until everybody was gone. And they went to Jesus. And they said, Jesus, why we couldn't do it? We've been with you all this long. We've walked with you. We've talked with you. We've prayed with you. We've watched you perform miracles. You empowered us. Why can we do it? Jesus said, since you ask, this kind come only by fasting and praying. Amen. Why did these 9 disciples fail? Because they have been careless, amen, in their faith. They have been careless in their personal walk with God. They have been careless and they neglected to fast and pray. And I'm here to tell you right now, Jesus can make it happen, but we got to keep on praying. He can make it happen if we pray and fast. And if we pray and fast, it glorifies God, which is in heaven. Amen. Let us stand as the doors of church is open. The power of faith to overcome the enemy. Look, we are fighting the enemy. Every day we're walking, every day God get us up, it won't be as the women say, peaches and cream. The devil coming at you. You say you're a Christian and you want to walk like Christ and be Christ-like. Well, he going to see if you're able to do that. Don't never tell him, don't, you know, you can test my faith all you want. And watch how he come at you to see if you have the patience. God's been good to us. And he have empowered us to defeat the enemy. So when people come to you, you know, those that paused on club hopping. Well, some of us just took a break. We ain't quit yet. Some of us took a break from just talking about folks. We ain't quit yet. Some of us took a break from mistreating folks, but we hadn't quit yet. But Jesus says that you need to quit all that and live just like him. So the doors of the church is open. I know if there's anyone here, we offering Christ to you that don't have a relationship with God. The Bible said that we should hear the word, we've heard it. Believe the word, it said, then we should repent of our sins, turn away. Amen. Be baptized if you die of baptism. You'll be saved. If anyone looking for a church home, we're looking for you. Maybe you all within the church, you all have a home, but you just need prayer. The altar's open for those that may need prayer. The Bible tells us that we should pray for one another, love one another. Amen. Prayer changes things. I'm still challenging the choir to learn that song, Don't Forget the Family Prayer. Prayer does some things. Amen. The songwriter said, prayer can go across the ocean faster than a plane can go. Amen. If you haven't had a talk with him, please do so. Yeah. Jesus want to hear from you. Just have a little talk with him. You call everybody else and tell them all your business. And then they turn around and say they ain't going to say it, and they call somebody else and tell all your business. But Jesus would never do that. Amen. He'll keep it a secret. We're going to pray. Let's just have a little talk with him. Tell him all about your trouble. He'll hear the cry. You got him? And he'll answer by and by. Let us pray. Choir, you may be seated. I need all of you to hold hands on this other side. We want to lock in. Let's lock in the Spirit of God. I want you to believe in your heart that God will answer. God says, we have not because we ask not. But when we go to him on one accord, he will answer. Father God, we come in Jesus' name. Lord, first thanking you for the altar. Thanking you, Lord, for allowing us to come to the altar and lay everything and leave it on the altar. For when we get up and we return from the altar, Father, it's still there. And Father, you're taking it and doing something with it. Father, many around the altar have purpose in their heart. They need you to move right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, Lord, the request that was granted, Father, that you would answer in the name of Jesus. Father, we know you're able, Father. There's nothing too hard for you. Father, you told us, Lord, that if we come to you in prayer, Father, believing that you're able, Lord, you said you would answer. Father, we believe it right now in Jesus' name. Father, we lift up health to you right now. Father, many are alien, many have some issues, Father, but there's no issue, there's no health concern that's too hard for you, for you created all of us, Father. You know all about us, Father. You know what's going on even when we don't know. You know what's going on even when the doctor can't figure it out. Father, you know because you've created. There's nothing too hard for you. Father, we're praying for bereaved families, Father, who've lost loved ones. Father, we know the Wilkerson family has lost some loved ones and have some sick people right now. Father, we lift up the McCrary family to you right now. We lift up Sister Prince and her family, the Bailey and the Robertson, for comfort right now, Father. For we know, Lord, that you didn't bring us this far to leave us, Father, but to let us know that you will be with us always, Lord, even until the end. Thank you, Father, for giving us the reassurance, Father, that if we leave this life, Father, that you have a better life for us, Lord. If we leave this life, Father, that we don't have to worry about any more bills, Father. If we leave this life, we don't have to worry about any more suffering. If we leave this life, we don't have to worry about any more pain. Lord, if we leave, Father, we go to the land of peace. Father, we're praying for peace among our families. We're praying for peace, Father, in our homes. Father, we're praying for peace in our schools, Father. We're praying for peace, Lord, on our jobs. Lord, we're praying, Lord, that your Holy Spirit will just be amongst each and every one, Father. Not only the ones that are around the altar, Father, but the ones that are in the pews, Father. The ones that may be watching from a social distance, Father. We pray for peace among each and every one. And then, Father, we pray for families. We pray for families, Father, to be mended, Father. We pray for broken hearts, Father, to be healed, Father. We pray for confused minds, Father, to be straightened out, Father. We pray, Lord, for any type of disconnect from us to you, Father, that you remove it, Lord, and that you would connect us, Lord, together, not as a church family, Father, but also as an immediate family. Father, we lift up our presiding elder to you. We pray, Lord, for healing in the name of Jesus. We pray that you would touch him, Father. Control, Lord, his cough, Father. Control his asthma, Father. Control him right now, Lord. Help him to feel better and better in the name of Jesus. Lift up his family to you, his wife and his children, his grandchildren, that you would keep them in perfect peace, Father. We lift up every member to you right now, Father. Whatever you see them standing in need of, Lord, that they don't know what they need, Lord, that you will provide it in Jesus' name. And Father, we'll be careful to give you all the honor and all the praise. Father, we claim victory, Lord, as we walk away from this altar, that our prayers are answered. In the name of Jesus, amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Reverend. The stewards would come for the offering.
Will everybody please stand as we bless the offering?
As we prepare for the Lord's Supper, thank you, stewards and ushers. Let's prepare our hearts and minds for the Lord's Supper. Amen. God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which you have shown toward his name, and that you have ministered to the saints and do minister. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation, atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. Wherefore you that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, and in love and harmony with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking henceforth in his holy way, draw near with faith and take the holy sacrament to your comfort, and devoutly kneeling, make your humble confession to the Almighty God. Those of you that are able to kneel may kneel at this time. Almighty God, Father of our Lord of Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against your divine majesty, provoking most justly your wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorrowful for our misdoing. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful upon us, most merciful Father, for your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us in all that is past, and grant that we may evermore hear and please you in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your great mercy has promised forgiveness of sin to all who with heartly repentance and true faith turn unto you, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring to us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Together, Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from whom no secrets are hid, Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We do not presume to come to this, your holy table, O merciful Lord, trust in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose property is to always have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may live and grow thereby, and that being washed through his most precious blood, may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of your tender mercy did give your only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by giving of himself once for all a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, offering and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of his death, his precious death, until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father. We humbly beg you and grant that we receive in these elements of bread and wine, according to your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, holy institution, and remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night which was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is the blood of the New Testament, which the covenant, which is shed for you and for many, and for the remission, pardoning of sins. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it." Amen. It is very meet and right and our bounden duty that we should at all times and all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, as angels and archangels and all beloved of our Lord, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord, Most High." Amen.
Have I overlooked anyone? The deaconess would come at this time. We thank God for our deaconess and the work they do. The ordination they hold is lifetime. Amen. We thank God for Sister Cotton. Amen. Sister Bosnick Smith. Sister Bosnick Smith. Let us recite the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom and the power. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we, your humble servants, desire your fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly asking you to grant that by the merits and depths of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and your whole church may obtain the forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And we offer and present unto you, O Lord, our souls and bodies to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice, humbly asking you that all who are partakers of his holy commandment, holy communion, we may feel with your grace and heavenly benediction. And although we are unworthy through our many sins to offer unto you any sacrifice, yet we ask that you
to accept this, our obligation to ministry and service, not we in our marriage, but pardon our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto you, O Father Almighty, world without end. Let us stand. Glory in excel. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. We praise thee. We bless thee. We worship thee. We glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takes away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takes away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. For thou sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. This ends our portion of the Lord's Supper. You may be seated.
Good afternoon, and these are the announcers for Sunday, October 1st, 2023 at St. Peter AME Zion Church. The Christian Education Department is asking for a $9 donation towards a dine-in or carry-out dinner to support our children and youth in attending the CD Midwinter Meeting this December in North Carolina. Tuesday, October 3rd, Stillman College presents a National Night Out in partnership with the Tuscaloosa Police Department and other community partners. This event will be held from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. and fun, food, fellowship, and entertainment will be provided. Also on Tuesday, Mass Choir rehearsal will be held at 6 o'clock p.m. Then join us for our weekly prayer teleconference call at 7 o'clock p.m. Wednesday, October the 4th, Adult Bible Study will be held at the new time at 6 p.m. in person and via Zoom as we study the book of 1 John and the second chapter. Children and Youth Bible Study will also be held in person at 6 o'clock p.m. in the church annex. Thursday, October the 5th, the Married Couples Ministry will meet at 6:30 p.m. Please contact Sister Cherie Robinson for more information. Sunday, October the 8th, all members ask to wear your pink as we recognize Breast Cancer Awareness Month and celebrate Pinktober. Also on Sunday, October the 8th, the Tuscaloosa Bessemer District 2023-24 lineup meeting will be held at 3 o'clock p.m. at Jerusalem AME Zion Church. Tuesday, October the 10th, the Adult CED and Outreach Ministry will be hosting a family game night from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. in the church annex. So come on out and join us for an evening of fun, food, and fellowship. Saturday, October the 14th, the class leaders and assistant class leaders will be hosting a program at 11 a.m. right here at St. Peter. Our CED Black History Moment. Larry L. Hester is a computer scientist and test director at Naval Surface Warfare Center, Panama City Division. She was recently chosen as the Woman of Color Technology Rising Star Award recipient. The Technology Rising Star Award recognizes young women with less than 15 years of career experience who are shaping technology for the future. Larry L. is the granddaughter of Sister Julia Prince, and congratulations. To our visitors, we offer you words of welcome. So, dear guests, our doors are always unlocked and open. So, come on in. This is the house of the Lord, and He is our host. We are all here by the same invitation. And since we share the Lord in common, let's be sure to greet each other after the parting blessing. So, on behalf of Reverend Patrick and Mrs. Shandra Freeman, we would like to say thank you for visiting with us today. Join us next week for our Sunday morning prayer call at 8:30 a.m., Sunday school at 9:30 a.m., morning worship service at 11 a.m., and the Chosen Generation Youth Church service at 11 a.m. in the church annex. We thank you for worshiping with us today, and we pray that you have a blessed, safe, and wonderful week ahead.
Thank you for the announcement, Sister Reva. Let you govern those announcements accordingly, those that can make the lineup meeting and some of the events that's going on. Let's be present if we can. I want to thank the chosen generation. You see our kids are coming out. Amen. They keep coming. They're going to outnumber the adults in here on Sundays. Amen. They say move on out the way. Children, also sign up for some of the ministries. Go back and look at the sign-up sheets over in the fellowship hall. Thank you, Sister Rouser, for getting those out. They're not there for decoration. Now, after the lineup meeting, don't come and say, well, you know, I wanted to do this and I wanted to do that. Amen. You got your opportunity right now. Amen. So thank you again for that. Let me thank the media ministry for making sure this message go out to the world. Amen. I'm preaching to you, but I'm preaching to those that's watching. And you'd be surprised at how many go back and look at the sermons and look at what we're doing. Amen. So, you know, when y'all in here, you know, putting makeup on your face, they see you. Amen. Just Moffitt. On today? All right, it's 65. What was it, y'all? What's it? Okay, if you 64 and a half, you ain't ready yet. Amen. 65 and older, those. It's 1 o'clock. I want to say one more thing. Good to see Sister Cox. Amen. Good to see you, Sister Cox. We'll talk. Amen. Last week, Sister Brown, Gerald Brown's wife, is that right? She come up to me and said, do you know Lorenzo Freeman? I said, yeah, that's my cousin. She said, well, that's Gerald's cousin too. And I said, what? I've never seen Gerald at any of our reunions. However, that's Lorenzo's first cousin. So we leave here and we go to Longhorn for dinner. We didn't get to eat because it was so long. And Lorenzo is walking out of Longhorn. His wife, my cousin Stephanie, their daughter. And it's just such a divine, you know, it's just confirmation. And, you know, I wanted to know for sure were they cousins. And Lorenzo said, yeah, that's my first cousin. Their mothers are siblings. Amen. So I might or may not be related. It depends on what the Spirit tells me. Amen. I think we're in the family. What a blessing. Make sure, do we have anybody visiting with us today? And how Stephanie knew, they posted on Facebook, your daughter posted on Facebook, the award that we gave them for music appreciation. And that's how all the connection came in. I'm like, wow, small world. I said, I'm glad I wasn't acting up around him. Amen. All right, nobody visiting with us today. Let us wave at ourselves. Amen. Ian going to Washington, and we want to make sure we lift him up in prayer. Ian and Salitris, thank you for representing St. Peter and the North Alabama Conference. We're going to pray safe travel. I don't know what Ian was doing. Y'all had him up all night or what? This. Okay, all right. All right. Amen. You excused, brother. Amen. Well, let us keep them lifted up in prayer and pray for them while they're there. that they represent, and God bless us, and definitely to bring that first place up. Amen. Amen. If there's nothing else to come before us, I want to thank all the teachers for the chosen generation, our directors, and for what they're doing. All the Sunday school teachers, our superintendents, everything, everybody that make it so much great. Don't forget, on Wednesday night, we open back up to try and bring the children in. In fact, we start at 6 this week. So if, you know, if your kid's at home and you don't have anything for them to do, I mean, I was told that, you know, we can come pick them up if you need us to. Amen. Give you a break. You know, when I was in the Church of Christ, them parents didn't mind dropping their kids off Wednesday night. It's like they didn't slow down enough for them to get out and just kept on rolling, you know. And they were back after Bible study to pick them up. But I don't know what's going on over here. We want them to learn what the Bible says. Amen. All right, if we have no visitors, make sure you stand, shake somebody's hand, tell them you love them. Amen. If you don't love them, just tell them you just like them right now. God's working on you. Amen. All right. May God be with you. While you're standing, Father God, we thank you for this worship service. We thank you, Lord, for allowing us to partake again in your bread, your broken body, your shedded blood for us to cleanse our sins. Father, we come in the name of Jesus, lifting up the Hughes family for traveling grace. We pray, Lord, that you would take them there safely and bring them back. Let them have a good time, Father. Keep your angels camped around the plane. Keep your angels camped around the cars. Keep your angels camped around the convention. Bring them back safely. Father, we pray for Kevin Stewart in the name of Jesus, that you would just protect him, keep him, heal him, comfort him, encourage him in the name of Jesus. Bless their home. Bless his family in the name of Jesus. Touch his wife, Father. Lord, help him walk hand in hand, side by side, Lord, lifting up your kingdom. Father, we come lifting up Sister Dudley in DCH, Father. We ask that you touch her in the name of Jesus. Heal her in the name of Jesus. Father, keep your angels camped around them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Now, Father, as we leave this place, but never your presence, watch over us all week long. Order our steps. Order our minds, our hearts, our spirits. May the things we say and do be pleasing unto you. Now may the grace of God and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit will rest, rule, and abide in all of our hearts. It is in Jesus' name we ask. Amen, amen, amen. I got one more announcement. Sister Smith and Benny and Cynthia Smith celebrate.